Good afternoon, all of you. First of all, I would like to raise my great thanks to the Social Watch for inviting me and to share with you our experience as I'm working in Sudan with a civil society organization focusing on human rights and gender issues. Maybe some of you know that Sudan is the largest Arab African country with huge resources in agriculture, in industries, in even human resources. The last census that affected Sudanese people more than 40 million people are living in Sudan with diversity. Some of them are Arab, some of them from Africa background, some of them are Muslim, the majority indigenous people are not Muslim with specific indigenous beliefs. This is the whole picture of Sudan. But unfortunately, Sudan practice or maybe suffer from internal conflict between different regions from the north and the south for more decades. For in Nuba Mountains as a part from west of Sudan, and lastly the four crises, as you know, as an international crisis. You see all this situation of internal conflict affected Sudanese people negatively. The majority of people are living in poverty. More than 69% of people are living under the line of poverty, even clarified by the UNDP. And the majority of those poor are women. If we look to gender profile in specific area related to human beings and human rights, what we found is that you see the basic rate of education in general is 45% for women, and women at the labor force are 27% only. In the agriculture sector, you find women constitute more than 97% of labor force. And in the irrigating sector, they are almost half of the labor force as the irrigating sector. Women in the civil services at the center is just 10%. Women in the industry sector is only 8%. Women headed household in general 25%, but as the conflicted area, they become 68%. Women in IDBs constitute mainly 70%, and most of these 70 are women. You see, this is a general picture of gender profile in Sudan, but in spite of the effort in Sudan which took place after CBA in 2005, this historical peace agreement between the North and the South, and the conflict resolution and peace building and the process to transport a democratic society started. But you see, there is general acceptance in Sudan that till now we are under the pressure of the economic crisis and under development factors. But in general, we as a civil society, we accepted three strategic points. Number one, the national development process have become the priority of all domestic policies in Sudan. Managing or influence the policies to change the tail 8 for trade to 8 for development. This is number one. Number two, we focus on the development is more than economic cross. We have to go beyond this definition of economic cross. We should clarify what do we mean by economic development rather than to just look to the figures of GDP or statistical analysis that carried by the economists. We look to the development as a multidimensional process. Should create a process to change the society, to change the culture, to change the economic situation, to increase the income of the people, and even to change the gender roles between men and women in our country. And the third one, we look to the aid, is the more than an institutions or agreements between our governments and the international community in terms of mechanics of economic relationship. We are looking to the aid, and we expect that aid should be delivered in terms of how we can create a quality of life of people. But within this process, and really within our country as a country, lack of democracy, lack of people participation in formulation of the policies, what we find on the ground is that there is three impacts of the economic crisis so clear in our country. Number one, what happened immediately after this economic crisis happened the last year, and actually I so believe this, it is not a financial crisis within the US system only, but it is a global crisis existed within the national and global, the profile and framework of the economic policies itself. And within the institutions, specifically the international institution, IMF and World Bank mandate and role in our countries in the survey. But in general, what happened on the ground is that immediately there is a huge cut of the budget, national budget, in terms of health services and education services. This is number one. Number two, there is increased prices of the food items, which affected the poor on the ground. Number three is the allocated of the agriculture land for the international companies to own money regardless of who is